Now, we are in the seedling section, and we will return to it later. At the moment, let's talk about our vegetarian greenhouse, which we have constructed using the latest technologies while adhering to the fundamental principles of vegetarians. Our greenhouse is divided into three sections, the seedling section where we are now, and two additional sections where you can provide specific microclimates to grow various plants. This division is very convenient. For example, you can grow tomatoes in one section, and cucumbers in the other one, or you can provide an environment for growing bananas and pineapples in one section with the temperature at around plus 30 C, while maintaining plus 12 C to plus 14 C in the other section. Such doors are quite interesting. So, now we are in the vegetarian greenhouse, constructed according to the fundamental principles of vegetarians. Besides, we applied some innovations. That's why today we will speak about vegetarian constructing, its fundamental principles, about things that can be improved or upgraded. One of the key principles of this vegetarium is the sloped ground. As you can see, it's inclined at about 15 to 16 degrees. This design allows the ground to accumulate heat from the sun efficiently, especially in winter when the sun is lower in the sky. Another innovative principle incorporated into this vegetarium is what's recognized as a feature of the fifth generation greenhouses. Excessive hot air, which usually accumulates at the top of the greenhouse, is pushed underground with the help of fans. This excessive heat is then stored and, if needed, can be used to heat the ground. This continuous airflow is highly beneficial for plant growth. It's known to agronomists and greenhouse managers that stagnant air can lead to plant diseases. In this greenhouse, there's a constant flow of air. Now, let's demonstrate the powerful fans. These fans can push air through the ground more than 10 times, ensuring efficient heat and air exchange. You can see how strong the airflow is. It easily moves a piece of paper. If we placed it closer, it would be blown away. Another principle we followed in building this vegetarium is enhancing the light intensity inside the greenhouse. To achieve it, we covered the north-facing wall of the greenhouse with a light-reflecting film. This matte film prevents glare and ensures even light distribution. Additionally, to capture more heat at the lower part, we coated it with black paint, enhancing the heat absorption in the lower section of the ground. Since the daylight hours are shorter in winter, we use sodium vapor lamps for supplementary lighting. These lamps provide 6,000 to 8,000 lumens per square meter, ensuring adequate lighting conditions for plant growth. In terms of heating, the primary heating elements are infrared panels. These panels are divided into groups, and the number of panels in use depends on the temperature requirements. This system is highly efficient, automated and convenient. Temperature sensors, concealed in the greenhouse, monitor and control the heating process. Moreover, we have an automated irrigation system that is divided into several zones. This section of the greenhouse consists of three zones, and it has a storage tank located in the upper part of the greenhouse. This tank autonomously heats up, and in case this section is not in use, the tank can be frozen for a certain period as well. One of the innovations we've incorporated into this vegetarium is automatic ventilation. Despite being a closed system, there are additional vents that can open automatically. This feature is particularly useful in case of power outages. In summer, the vegetarium can heat up rapidly, reaching temperatures of 60 to 70 degrees Fahrenheit within just a couple of hours. In such cases, the automatic vents open to release excessive hot air. Sometimes, the main fans may not be sufficient to cool down the greenhouse, so these additional vents serve as a valuable backup. Now, let's take a look at the seedling section. Here, you can see the galvanized steel shelves where you can grow various seedlings. These shelves are highly durable and can hold up to 150 kilograms each. The seedling section can operate autonomously, meaning it has its own heating, lighting, and environmental control system. LED lights are used here to provide an optimal spectrum of light for seedlings. If they are not needed, they can be turned off. The central control unit of the greenhouse, often referred to as its brain, is located here. It houses temperature regulators, timers, humidity relays, and other systems that help maintain the necessary microclimate. The heating system in this greenhouse is multi-stage, allowing for different numbers of heaters to be activated depending on the temperature. This means that when the temperature drops sharply, more heating systems are activated, and when it rises, some can be turned off. This multi-stage heating system significantly reduces heating costs and helps to unload the overall electrical supply system. To sum up, this vegetarium is designed with a variety of innovative features to create the ideal conditions for plant growth while ensuring energy efficiency and environmental control. It's a well-thought-out system that can be adapted to different crops and environmental conditions, making it an excellent choice for sustainable and efficient greenhouse cultivation.